So track versions, this is my term, not Steinberg's term. I think of anything to do with track as your x-axis. Tracks go down the road in time, whereas channels on your mixing board run up and down. So I think of track versions as an x-axis comparison tool and channel comparisons as a y-axis tool, but that's just my odd view of the world. So if you simply drop down the menu next to a track name, it's going to give you the option to create versions. And now they're going to sit on top of each other rather than copy and paste stuff. Before this came out, I think a lot of people would say, like, I want to try three different shots at the guitar track. They would copy and paste the track, duplicate the entire track three times and then mess with it, which is just messy. So if you create a new version of this track, you'll see that in this case, everything disappeared. And we see guitar version two. It disappeared because it's expecting you to play a new version of that take. All right, that's not really what we wanted here. So I'm going to delete that version, go back to where we started. And what you're probably going to use more often is you'll have a take that's pretty good and you want to mess with different editing functions or what have you. In that case, you want to make a duplicate version. And now the project window waveform stays the same, but you can see we're working with a copy of version one. And you can rename that, of course, if you want to call this, you know, Stan's version, whatever. You can make a duplicate of that. And it's a duplicate of a copy of Stan's version and so forth. And presumably with each one of these, you'd be going in and making edits and changes. You don't need to watch me do that. You can move between the versions at the top. You've already seen how to delete it. And this is an interesting function. Select tracks with same version ID. If you're doing this gag on several tracks at once, right? So you've got like the bright version and the dark version or whatever, but you're doing it on your guitar and your bass and your brass, whatever. Assuming that you're doing those versions in formation, you can use that function. Let's select all of the version twos, all the version threes, and jump between different versions on a multi-track level. So we'll go back to the beginning on that one. Not that it really matters here. Okay, and then let's go ahead into the editor for this. All right, in previous versions of Cubase, those of you who are upgrading, this icon used to say AB, which is a little bit cryptic, I guess. They've changed it to the Activate Channel Comparison function. And the whole idea here is to AB one channel to another. And I'm using the EQ as an example because that's one where there's a strong operational value of seeing visually what you're doing on different channels. So if we turn this function on, it's going to light up a blue and a amber window at the top. And obviously we're looking at the guitar track's EQ. If I want to compare that to the EQ that I have for, let's say, the ambience track, I can select that as my comparison channel. And then when you click here, you see ambience. When you click here, you see guitar. Now, let me turn this back off. And just to compare and contrast, you could just select the different channels. And because these are adjacent, it would be easy to do with the up and down control here. There's the guitar, there's the ambience. So this gag works because these two are right next to each other. But if you've got 30 tracks and you want to compare this one to that one, that's a lot of clicking and pawing around. The comparison function lets you jump between more easily. And on the comparison, it lights up the background in the track color. I think it'd make it visually easier to see which one you're looking at. And again, you don't need to listen to me play those back. But this is sort of your y-axis comparison, moving down your mixing board, looking back and forth.